It was dressed up as a trade debate, but it wasn't really a trade debate at all. There was no economic merit in what has been proposed at all. And indeed, as an indicator of that, not merely was I opposed to the proposal, but the crossbench peer, Lord Mervyn King, the former governor of the Bank of England, who knows a thing or two about economic policy, he voted against it. It's a political thing. It's in trying to reverse the referendum thing. And what I was making the point to which you refer was that if we are the customs union, without being in the European Union as such, we are being governed, in effect, by the European Union. And that is what I call the quasi-colonial status.
Right. Do you think what happened in the Lords, bearing in mind it was a fairly broadly worded amendment, do you think it might compel the government to soften its stance?
I hope not, because it makes a nonsense. You can't effectively leave the European Union unless you leave, as the government has made absolutely clear, and as we made it clear during the Brexit campaign, without leaving both the customs union and the single market. I mean, the legitimacy of what the Lords have done is to say, well, it is reasonable on an important issue as this for the House of Commons to think again. But if the House of Commons thinks again and decides not to support this amendment or anything like it, then I think the House of Lords, the unelected House of Lords, would be very ill-advised to pursue its objections. I mean, there is always the case with the two houses are at odds of the peers versus the people. But in this case, it's not merely the people's elected representatives in the Lords, but the people of this country who voted clearly in a referendum.
Right,
but they wanted to leave the European
Union. But people like Chris Patten aren't going to back down or change their tune, are they?
No, there are a few fanatics, I agree, who won't back down. But I think the majority of sensible peers will realise that at the end of the day, if the House of Commons thinks again, then we in the House of Lords should accept that the House of Commons is the democratically elected House.